them were from poor families. The queen seated herself at the head of the table and said, "You may now sit down. I hope you enjoy the meal." Suddenly, all the boys scrambled to get food, hungrily gobbling it all up and stuffing their faces. The queen didn't say anything. She just sat down quietly, picked up her napkin, and started to eat. This went on for a while. Then out of the corner of her eyes, out of the chaos, she saw a little boy sitting in front of her, fixing the napkin on his lap and trying his best to eat a fork and a knife. And guess who it was? That's right, Gopal. Gopal had no more training in table manners than any of the other boys. But he knew to follow the best example at the table. And by that evening, the queen had made her choice and crowned Gopal the king of Baroda.
Good evening, everyone. Yes, Ben is going to sing two songs. The first one says that God, my Lord, our Lord, very soon is going to move his wicked ways. So everything bad that is happening here, very soon God is going to move it, going to change everything. And the second song tells us about that Jesus coming soon. I will pray to go to heaven with him.
My Lord, can you please speak and pray? Thank you. It's more than mini Olympic.
Don't have time for the children. Thank you. sort of an information satellite. It gives you an idea whenever we sing a certain song about ships and anchors and rain and storm. For your information, I'm a sailor by profession, and I have sailed almost all over the world. After 15 years at sea, well, the company decided they need somebody to take care of the management of ships, so I decided to work in the corporate office until today. Today we talk about anchors. Well, as everybody knows, the anchor is a device, especially made of metal, that used to protect the vessel from the bottom, but it was never to make it part of the building to the wind. It's as simple as that. And later on, we will realize how the anchor or the chain or the ship or the storm connects us to our spiritual life. The anchor has been considered and recognized as a symbol of stability, steadfastness, durability, or safety and security. And ancient excavations have realized that people a long time ago have been using anchors. Ancient anchors usually consist of heavy boulders or rocks with a hole in between where they have to go fast to a wax, rope, or a hemp to make it passable to the boat. Well, the anchor usually stored in the part of the vessel and is connected to the wall, we call it bulkhead, and we usually call it the feeder end. So that means when all your anchor is done, it comes to the feeder end. And the chain, they're not light, they're heavy stuff. It's made usually weighs 30 kilos. That's why some of them are used for this Ironman pumpers. And imagine how those and you're pulling more than 100 kilos. Now, the anchor is here with us. It's an area where ship can set the anchor. It must be sandy, clay, mud, or silt. But also sufficient depth, not big rocks or round bones, great shipwrecks, and never a dumping area. Now, I'd like to call your attention on sufficient depth. In the Christian life, sufficient depth means God is near. God is a whisper away, or only God is a fire away. Too deep and your anchor will not reach it. Too shallow and your vessel gets grounded. And no God is dumping area in Christian life. That means Christians should never place their hope and faith on sorcerers, on people with crystal balls, on people wielding cards, or wielding bombs, or throwing stones and sticks and bones and leave your future. To God, those are garbage. Never. Don't have your anchor on a garbage dumping area. How to anchor? Safe anchoring, slow speed, face the wind, that when you face your ship, you turn your ship to the wind, drop the anchor, the chain is 5 times the length of the depth of the water, after the propulsion, you check the anchor holding. How the anchor holds? First, that one. Second, as you pull it, the spike is beginning to bite on the ground, and then you pull it again, it's beginning to bite deeper until you get your anchor holding. The first slide there represents that means when your anchor is holding, it's drifting. It's not biting. And the way anchor is to bring it toward the vessel preparation for departure. Anchor's away, like this, is that means they're ready to depart. There's no such thing as anchor's away. We don't use that. It's anchor's away when you do that. Now, the problem with the anchor is what we call anchor thinking. This happens when it's stuck in wildcat. The one is a big round thing there, it's a wildcat. Due to the effect of juice, twisting, or a proper storage in the chain lever. That's anchor twisting. That's anchor thinking. so it will not roll over and you can drop your anchor. Right? Now, to prevent that, the anchor should be taken out every 2.5 years, have it inspected, have it cleaned, have it painted, check the connections, and also inspect the connections there if it's okay. In the Christian life, that means prayer and fasting. I'm not saying not to fast every 2.5 years. What I'm saying is it should be a regular part of the Christian life where you have to clean, endurance, your anchor and your chain. Now, remember this song? You're very familiar with this song. I would like to call attention to the red line there, the red words. It will strain. When the other apple keep on firm with me, when the strong pipe speak. Do I know how much force you need to stop a 65,000 ship from drifting toward the shores of the Malian Reef in the rocks? Almost 200 tons. That's 3 times the weight of the ship. When storms come into your life, brethren, your chain of prayer is under tremendous strain to prevent you from drifting into the rocks. Almost 200 tons. A ship which loses its anchor and is strong will be lifted to the rocks ashore, will be the first of the wind and waves, will be eventually damaged beyond repair. When it comes to ship business, a ship which loses the anchor will lose insurance coverage and it becomes a liability for acceptable risk. A Christian who loses his trust and faith in the power of God and loses his belief in prayer will be no longer under the direction and guidance of the Holy Spirit and will be very gay for the living. It's that simple. Right? Remember this song? I would like to draw the attention to this red words passing to the rock which cannot move. At the same door, our cardinal sin, we call it cardinal sin, is never, never to have your anchor caught on the rock. Never. Why? Because the rock which you got your anchor into, you never know if that is rock the rest below. You never know if that is part those of the whole island and you're practically pulling the whole island, or that could probably be part of the mountain waves that you see in the distance. So if you catch a caught or foul, your anchor on a rock, you can never be. Unless you cut your chain, and that will place you under no insurance coverage. Right? However, in a Christian life, having your anchor caught on a rock is good. Why? You'll never get drifted. Because you're fastened to the rock, which cannot move, which is Jesus. Okay? Now, remember this song? Heaven behind is what we gave. My anchor holds within the gift. Gift has two meanings. Holy bodies, God's dwelling place. In American language, it calls horizontal rain. Rain usually goes this way. However, when the rain goes horizontal, that means what? You land up. Very, very strong wind. If your anchor holds within the scope of this horizontal rain, that means you have a very good chain, very good anchor, and you have got your anchor fastened on the rock. You are secure. Okay? Now, let me show you this. When we drop our family out, okay? 2007, I was diagnosed with cancer. It started with nosebleed. I want to get stopping now, so my life knows no thrill. So one day, I get nosebleed. We had it checked, and the doctor said, it's cancer. See that white spot over there? That's cancer. It's as big as your thumb, right here. Okay? You know what happens when a doctor tells you you have cancer? You get your whole life just like a video, and you can see the ending. Right? Things come into your mind, plenty of things. What happened to my wife? What happened to my daughter? What about the dog? What about everything? Okay? And you start to, and you cannot sleep. Right? You think about everything, unbelievable. Right? And then after that, because my immunity was down, I was diagnosed with TB. So I get cancer, I get the tuberculosis. Right? After that, the doctor said I get diabetes. If the normal blood sugar is 120, I get 400. Right? And because of graduation, when I have the radiation treatment, I become deaf in 1 year. I can hear you when you speak to me inside. You have the world people can show me. Okay, so if you want to speak to me, you speak to me inside. Right? And to make matters worse, I was taken out of the job. Okay? The company which I was working for 30 years decided to take out the stocks, and they said, we don't have the procedure for you. So, I have insulin twice a day. You have these four injections. Morning on the right side, evening on the left side. Morning on the right side, evening on the left side. Okay? I had 39 sessions of radiation treatment. You know what happens when you do the radiation treatment? You survive by not working. You have no survival. And you cannot swallow without saliva. Right? You know, sometimes it's funny how we take things for granted. We just say that, okay, we get saliva. But you know what? Without saliva, you cannot swallow. That's why maybe today, when I eat, I must eat drink that I have a big glass of water beside me, or else I can't swallow. Right? And I get chemotherapy for sessions at the Asian hospital. You know what happens with the chemotherapy? It kills the good cells also. And they're killing something from the inside. And I get less than her. That's me when I was chubby from 77 and down to 55. Right? Right? And I was very young, my daughter, which was about 8 years old. I was, that's before, after. Before, after. Let's see that. Right? Right? Let me ask you this. Who likes vegetable fruit shake? Who likes fruit shakes? You like fruit shake? Very good. Can you have fruit shake twice a day? How about 3 times a day? How about fruit shake for a year? Nothing but fruit shakes. Vegetable and fruits. My wife shakes every day for 1 year. No rice, no potato, no meat, no chicken, no hamburger, nothing. Shake, shake, shake. Every day, 3 times a day for 1 year. Okay? Now, if you're the company and I would apply for you, would you accept something like this? Diabetic with cancer can appear 1 year out of job and 53 years old. Would you accept me? I don't think so. I would accept somebody who's old and sick, diabetic and dead and cancer. Right? Of course not. Okay? Well, I tell you, I was accepting it. And I already, you know how we get to that? I'm going to tell you something. We don't know how we did get through that. I only remember four things: kneeling, praying, Bible reading, and fighting. That's all I remember. And it taught me two things. One, we are nothing but God. And number two, nothing is impossible. Right? Start for a couple of people like that. No issue about that. It's not a question of if, it's when the storm comes into your life. It will come and make it work financially, physically, maybe you get sick, or maybe emotional, spiritual, family, whatever. But when they do come, I want you to face the wind. Just like when you do face your ship, face your fear, face your worry, face your problem, your challenge, the liver, and look at them straight in the eye. And when you face with the book, right? And have the same thought that runs through your mind, the same thought that runs through David's mind when he confronted the lion, the same thought that runs through David's mind when he was fallen to the lion's den. The same thought that runs through the mind of the Jewish boy, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, when they were thrown in the fiery furnace. The thought that says, not today. Not today. Lose my hope in the love of God? Not today. Lose my faith in the power of prayer? Not today. Lose the guidance and give direction to the Holy Spirit? Not today. For the love of God, not today. For the grace of God, not today. And for the power of God, not today. And tomorrow, let's look to the Bible. And the day after that. Not today. Tomorrow, when you wake up, the first thing that comes into your mind, not today. With the love of God, with the power of God, not today. And drop your anchor. Drop your anchor of hope and faith to the rock of deliverance, to the rock of salvation, to the rock which cannot go, to Jesus, the rock of ages. So, brethren, let me ask you, how is your chain of prayer? How is your anchor of hope and faith? Can it withstand the storm when it comes? It is my prayer tonight when I pray that I will ask the Lord, to take away that place of rust and fear, to take away that place of rust of doubts, and grant you a brand new chain and brand new anchor that you can use any time and fasten your hope and faith in Jesus, the rock. All glory.
Well, it is time for our closing prayer. We will launch that right now. But our closing prayer is in the form of a beautiful song to our Lord Jesus. As we remain standing, please pray to God as we hear this song. This will be our final prayer.
Oh.
Tonight, and God bless all of you. Thank you so much.